Blackstone Audio presents Global Brain, The Evolution of Mass Mind from the Big Bang to the 21st Century by Howard Bloom. This book is read by Malcolm Hillgartner. To Richard Metzger, Florian Retzer, Bradley Fisk, and E. Barton Chapin, Jr. There are few observers who possess a clear and comprehensive view of the revolutions of society, and who are capable of discovering the nice and secret springs of action which impel, in the same uniform direction, the bland and capricious passions of a multitude of individuals. Edward Gibbon. Don Juan, out of all patience. By heaven, this is worse than your cant about love and beauty. Granted that the great life force has hit on the device of the clockmaker's pendulum and uses the earth for its bob, that the history of each oscillation, which seems so novel to us the actors, is but the history of the last oscillation repeated. Nay, more, that in the unthinkable infinitude of time, the sun throws off the earth and catches it again 1,000 times as a circus rider throws up a ball, and that our age-long epochs are but the moments between the toss and the catch. I, my friend, am as much a part of nature as my own finger is a part of me. If my finger is the organ by which I grasp the sword and the mandolin, my brain is the organ by which nature strives to understand itself. The Devil. What is the use of knowing? Don Juan. Why, to be able to choose the line of greatest advantage, instead of yielding in the direction of the least resistance. Does a ship sail to its destination no better than a log drifts nowhither? The philosopher is nature's pilot, and there you have our difference. To be in hell is to drift. To be in heaven is to steer. George Bernard Shaw. Prologue. Biology, Evolution, and the Global Brain. Since the infancy of the personal computer in 1983, authors and scientists have been churning out works on the subject of a coming global brain strung together by computer networking. Today, the Internet, the World Wide Web, and its successors allow a neuroscientist in Strasbourg to swap ideas instantly with a philosopher of history in Siberia and an algorithm juggler in Silicon Valley. But according to the visionaries who predict a world-spanning intelligence, this is just the beginning. They tell us that a radical human transformation has begun, one that will hook the billions of minds of humanity together into a single system, like Gaia growing herself a nervous system. We will soon come together, predict the techno-prophets, on a post-World Wide Web computer net that will learn our ways of thought and fetch us the knowledge we need before we know we want it. A web that will turn the human race into a single, spiritual superbeing, a massive, collective conscious that will even incorporate the brains of computer-equipped whales in distant seas. The result will be one of the greatest leaps in the evolution of our species. My 20 years of interdisciplinary work indicate that beneath these visions lurks a strange surprise. Yes, the computerized linking of individual minds is likely to bring considerable change. But a worldwide neocortex, complete with whales, is not a gift of the Silicon Age. It is a phase in the ongoing evolution of a networked global brain which has existed for more than 3 billion years. This planetary mind is neither uniquely human nor a product of technology, nor is it a result of reincarnation or an outgrowth of telepathy. It is a product of evolution and biology. Nature has been far more clever at connectionism than have we. Her mechanisms for information swapping, data processing, and collective creation are more intricate and agile than anything the finest computer theoreticians have yet foreseen. From the beginning, we've been yanked together by the tug of sociality. 3.5 billion years ago, our earliest cellular ancestors, bacteria, evolved in colonies. Each bacterium couldn't live without the comfort of rubbing against its neighbors. If it was separated from its companions, a healthy bacterium would rapidly divide to create a new society filled with fresh compatriots. Each colony of these single-celled foremothers faced warfare, disaster, the hunt for food, and windfalls.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.